Today is January 22nd, 2022. This is Mordecai, host of the updates, bringing you your daily Elden Ring update. There's no news about Elden Ring today per se, but I just wanted to talk about this as it could be relevant when Elden Ring comes out. Basically, earlier today, a new exploit was discovered for the PC version of Dark Souls 3, where if you're playing online, another player you're connected to can remotely execute code on your PC. Meaning they can get a hold of your PC and do what they want with it, like steal personal info or execute malicious malware. Now, the good news is that this exploit is not public yet as of now. A person who isn't malicious discovered it, tried to contact From to no avail, and then they decided to raise awareness on the issue by harmlessly displaying it on a Twitch streamer who was playing some Dark Souls 3 multiplayer last night. They did this by invading them, crashing their game, and running a text-to-speech code in PowerShell.
I will leave you with this cause I'm wasting time. Talking all you want, Grim. You put that much hours in the same thing.
What the f***?
First you have to be sick in the head to do and second.
Alright, so what can you do to prevent this? Well, the absolute surefire way is to launch Dark Souls 3 in offline mode for now. This isn't a great solution because then you won't be able to play co-op, see messages, or do invasions, but at least you eliminate the risk of malicious attacks. The second option is the Blue Sentinel mod. For those that don't know, Blue Sentinel is a mod that identifies cheaters, prevents dangerous effects from ruining your save files, and lets you kick malicious players from your world. If you don't know what it looks like, it's basically the overlay you see on top of the screen in the PvP clips I use in the background of videos. But anyway, as of this recording, the mod does not yet prevent this exploit. However, the developers of it have been made aware of the exploit by the person who discovered it, and they're currently working on releasing a new version of the mod that can help prevent this. You can download the mod from the Nexus Mod website. So, what does this mean for Dark Souls 3 going forward, and more importantly, Elden Ring? Well, FromSoft have stopped support for Dark Souls 3 as they have not updated it in nearly 5 years. So unless a new contract is formed between them and Bandai on this, I'm not sure they will patch it. Additionally, Elden Ring uses the same engine as Dark Souls 3, and it will likely have the same netcode, meaning it's likely that this exploit will be possible upon the release of the PC version. However, the good news is that the Bandai Namco community manager for Dark Souls and Elden Ring stated in the official Discord server that they're aware of this issue and it's been reported to the appropriate internal sources. So hopefully they can fix this issue not only for Dark Souls 3, but for Elden Ring as well, as the game is very near its launch and an exploit of this scale would jeopardize playing the PC version online. So yeah, I just wanted to give a quick PSA and explain the situation to those of you who play Dark Souls 3 on PC still and plan on playing Elden Ring there as well. I'll let you know if there's any updates on this matter, but for now I would not recommend playing Dark Souls 3 online on PC. So anyway, stay safe out there, and for now, this has been your daily Elden Ring update for January 22nd, 2022.